children, welcome in my SST class. Today we will start a new chapter from the civic side, and that is how the state government works. Okay, so let's start. You know that India is a federal union with 28 states and 9 union territories. India has a federal form of government. So the question is, what is the meaning of federal form of government? Federal means that there are two levels of government, one at the center and another in the states and union territories. The constitution has divided the power and function of two government in clear terms. Both the central and state government have three organs: executive, legislature and judiciary. So look at the table. Okay, so government, three organ of government: executive, legislature and judiciary. Okay, so what is the meaning of legislature? Legislature means the law making body of government. Executive means to implement the law passed by the parliament. Okay, passed by the parliament. And judiciary means interprets and enforces this law. Government has three organs, and these are executive, legislature and judiciary. Each of these organs performs certain functions as specified in the constitution. We shall discuss the state government works in details in this chapter. You know, legislature means the lawmaking body of government. So legislature in the union parliament, or we can say the legislature in the central level, can be divided in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is also called as the lower house, and Rajya Sabha is also called as the upper house. You know, the member, not more than 552 members obviously should be there in the lower house, or we can say Lok Sabha, not more than 250 members in Rajya Sabha. A member should be 25 years of the age for the Lok Sabha. A member should be 30 years of age for the Rajya Sabha. Tenure or the time limit for the Lok Sabha is 5 years and tenure 2 years for the Rajya Sabha. Remember, Rajya Sabha is also called as the permanent body of government, permanent body. Members are elected from the constituencies. These terms we will discuss in later. Members elected by state legislative assembly. Got it now? Then we can say the legislature in the state. Remember, again, the legislature in the state can be divided in the terms of Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad. Vidhan Sabha is also called as legislative assembly. Vidhan Parishad is also called as legislative council. The works are same as it Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Vidhan Sabha is also called as lower house, and Vidhan Parishad is also called as upper house. Composed of elected members like Lok Sabha, and members are indirectly elected for the Vidhan Parishad. Okay, the members are called as MLA. Okay, so the full form of MLA is Members of Legislative Assembly. And for Rajya Sabha, or we can say the Vidhan Parishad, Members of Legislative Council. Members of Legislative Council. Tenure for the Vidhan Sabha is 5 years, and for Vidhan Parishad, it is also called as the permanent house, each member serves for terms of 6 years. I'm going to repeat, each member serves for term of 6 years, and 1/3 of its members retire after every 2 years. Now, we are going to discuss the state legislature and it works in details. There is a representative form of government at the state level. Every state has a legislature. Election held to choose the members of the state legislature. Some states have a unicameral legislature. So what is the meaning of unicameral? Unicameral means they have only one house of legislature. Other states have two houses of legislature, means bicameral legislature. Two houses are the Legislative Assembly, or we can say the Vidhan Sabha, and another is called as the Legislative Council, or we can say the Vidhan Parishad. Okay, now we are going to discuss the Legislative Assembly or Vidhan Sabha. In India, every state has a legislative assembly which has members in proportion to the state population. The members of the legislative assembly are elected by the people who form the government. Okay? So remember, the state legislative assembly is also called the lower house, already we discussed. Okay, and its terms is for 5 years. Okay, 5 years. Composition. The constitution states that the number of members in legislative assembly cannot exceed more than 500 and cannot be less than 60. Remember, every state is divided into different areas known as constituencies. So what is the meaning of constituencies? According your book, constituencies means a particular area from which all the voters living there choose their representative. This could be, for example, a panchayat ward or an area that choose an MLA. Okay, so remember, every state is divided into different areas known as constituencies. Let us take an example of the state of Uttar Pradesh, which is divided into 403 constituencies. From each constituency, one representative is elected by the people. So this representative may belong to any political party or can be an independent candidate. The political party which win more than half of the numbers of the seat in a state in an election gains the majority and forms the government. So what is the meaning of majority? According your book, the majority means this is a situation when more than half the number in a group support a decision or an idea. This is also called a simple majority. Got it now? So remember, the political party which win more than half a number of seats in a state in an election gain the majority and forms the government. This is called the simple majority. And the political party that has the majority is called the ruling party, and all other members are called the opposition. According your book, the opposition refers to an elected representative who are not members of the ruling party and who play the role of questioning government decisions and actions as well as raise new issues for consideration in the assembly. We can take one example from your book, page number 32. Okay, look at, for example, the legislative assembly of the state of the Himachal Pradesh has 68 MLA constituencies. Already we discussed what is the meaning of MLA and what is the meaning of constituencies. So candidates from various political parties own the 2003 assembly elections and become MLAs. Since the total number of MLAs in the legislative assembly is 68, okay, a political party would have needed to have more than 34 MLAs in order to gain a majority. Already we discussed what is the meaning of majority. The Indian National Congress with 43 MLAs had the majority and it became the ruling party. All other MLAs become the opposition. In this case, Bharatiya Janata Party was the major opposition party since it had the largest number of MLAs after the Indian National Congress. So, ruling party in Himachal Pradesh in 2003 is obviously the Indian National Congress and the opposition is Bharatiya Janata Party. Got it now? Among the opposition were other parties, including those who had been elected as independent candidates. After the election, the MLAs belonging to the ruling party will elect their leader, who will become the chief minister. Got it now? So in this case, the Congress Party MLAs choose Sri Birvadra Singh as their leader and he become the chief minister. The chief minister then selects other people as minister. After the election, it is the governor of the state who appoints the chief minister and other minister. Remember my children, the governor, chief minister and the other minister are called as the executive part of the state. Okay, so I think you have got a clear concept about the constituencies, MLA, okay, Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad. We will meet in our next class. Okay, bye.